Hey guys, imagine you're working as a business analyst in a retail company that sells vacuum cleaners. Suddenly, you're getting a call from the marketing department saying that they have changed the name of one of their products. Instead of the Dirtinator, the new product name will be the Dustinator. You, as a business analyst, have hundreds of Excel files that still include the old product name. Finding and replacing all product names might be very tedious if you do it manually. However, after watching this video, you will be able to find and replace multiple values in multiple Excel files within seconds using Python. Okay, and without further ado, let us get started. To kick things off, let us begin with a simple example. In my workbook, I've got some financial data. In column A, we will see different segments of the business. I intend now to replace mid-market with mid-size market and small business with small market. I want to do this change across the entire workbook, so also in the second worksheet. To do this in Python, I will be using the openpyxl library. To install the module, fire up your command prompt or terminal and type pip install openpyxl. Once done, I will open up a blank Python file. First, I will import openpyxl. Then I will create a Python dictionary. The key within this dictionary is the text you want to find in your Excel file. And the respective value is the text you want to replace it with. So, as an example, I would like to find small business and replace it with small market. And with that in place, I will load our workbook by typing openpyxl.loadWorkbook followed by the Excel file path. As my Python file is in the same directory as my Excel file, I only need to type the file name here. However, later in the video, I will show you a better solution when working with file paths. But for now, I will leave it as it is. With that said, I will now loop over each worksheet of our workbook. Within each worksheet, I want to iterate over the columns and rows, search for the text, and replace it. To iterate over all cells, I will use iter rows. Within each row, I will write another loop to access the cells. Now I can check if the cell value is within our dictionary key. Remember, the dictionary key are the following ones. If that is the case, I want to replace the current cell value with the respective value in my dictionary. And that is all there is to it. As a last step, I will save this as a separate workbook. After executing this script, let me open up our new workbook. Looking at column A, we can see that we have successfully replaced the values. Also, in the second worksheet, openpyxl has changed the values. Now that we have our working script, let us take it one step further. I will copy the script and paste it into the second example. In this example, we want to find and replace the values for all workbooks within the files folder. By the way, our script will also work if you have additional subfolders which might contain even more Excel files. And with that said, let me switch back to our Python file. As we will be dealing with different file paths, I will import path from pathlib. Pathlib comes with Python 3.4 and above. So, no additional installation is required. Next, I'm going to specify our base directory. Currently, I have saved this Python file under the following path. The parent directory would be this part of the file path. And this is the information I'm storing in the base dir variable. Next, I will specify our input directory, so the folder with the Excel files. In my case, the folder is called files. Additionally, I will set up an output directory to save our new Excel files. With pathlib, we can also easily create this folder if it doesn't already exist. To do so, you can use the make directory method on the output directory. By setting parents to true, pathlib will create any missing parent directory of this path. If the directory already exists, pathlib will raise an error. By setting exist OK to true, we will ignore this error. To store all Excel file paths of our folder, I will create a list called files. I will use rloop on the input directory to return the file paths. Also, I only want to store files that include XLS in the file ending. By the way, if you only want to list the files without the subfolders, you can use loop instead of rloop. Once we have the list with all Excel file paths, we can iterate over it. The only thing left to do is to replace Canada with file and to save it to our output directory. I will use the file name for the workbook name with the underscore new. Executing this script takes less than 2 seconds. And to validate that it worked, I will open up one spreadsheet. After setting the filter on column A, we see that openpyxl has replaced the values. Okay guys, and that is all for this tutorial. As always, if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.